So I got the delivery of my Samsung S10 Plus. Today was the official release date of the S10 series in Australia. This video is not about the phone, but rather something else. The included earphones. Something that Samsung officially, at this point in time, is not making too much fuss about. Or not any more than usual, that is. Let's see what they have actually done. I have covered this topic for a long time, going back many years now. The pattern is, every two models, Samsung has been updating their included earphones. Meaning, the S4 and S5 had these somewhat decent in-canal earphones that were presentable for its time. Then in S6 and S7 series, Samsung went into a slightly different direction with their new design, and that was either loved or hated by the users. Then, with great fanfare, in the S8 and S9 series, they had the AKG tuned earphones. There was a bit of controversy due to the way Samsung announced these earphones. It came across as AKG was making these earphones, but they only tuned it, they did not manufacture it. The common complaint was that these earphones were a bit of a letdown in the bass section. With the history out of the way, let's see what we have with the S10. True to the pattern of changing the earphones every two models, the S10 now has a new set of earphones. Or so it appears on the surface. As we can see, there is new color theme here. Samsung has returned to the original white look with its included earphone. Shape-wise, it appears to be identical to the previous AKG tuned earphones. The inline mic and the jack are also identical. I can see signs of some changes that they may have made. The S10 series earphone cable appears to be slightly thicker than the previous version. It's hard to say if it is just the braiding that is thicker, or they may have tweaked the insulation material, or the gauge, or the nature of wiring perhaps, which may affect the resistance. I don't know the inside story, just that visibly it's a little bit thicker. We looked at the Samsung's IG935 previously. It's uncanny how they resemble each other. The cable portion is exactly the same. The body of the earphone has many common attributes as well. Now all that is fine and good. The real pressing question here was, apart from the change in color, did Samsung do anything else? Is the sound any different? So I went straight to the usual tests at my computer, which has a Sonar DX sound card. Tested it for a few different genres, testing them side by side, the answer was clear. Yes, they didn't just change the color. Samsung has tweaked the inside as well. And I'm pleased to say they have been listening. They fixed what everyone complained about, the bass. The mid and the treble appears to be as they were. I did not perceive a major enough change, and that is fine. However, now that the bass is fixed, the sound appears more complete. It seems to me this is what Samsung originally may have attempted to do when they brought out AKG to do the tuning, but took them two releases to get there. In case if you are wondering, despite some similarities, the IG935 is not up to the level of the new earphone either. It is a serviceable product for the price paid, although I would recommend the Brainwaves Delta over it if anyone is looking for a cost-effective earphone. But that is a different topic I'll cover in an upcoming video. As at this point, the answer is clear without much room for doubt. The new earphone may look similar but is indeed new and improved. So, going by the pattern, S11 will have these earphones as well, but S12 may get something new. And I hope they keep the positive momentum going. After all, that was the whole point of making these videos over the years, with hope for improvement. Thank you for watching this video, I hope you have enjoyed it. There are some other points about the S10 that I would like to talk about, but that is a different subject for another day. I hope to see you in my next video. Bye for now.